Hey folks, I'm Commander RedFalcon, and welcome to the stream. We are currently one jump away from rendezvous point, and let's see here. Let me pull up the codex real quick. And right now we're in the Arcadian stream region of space. So we went from Galactic Center, Riker's Hope, and now we're in Arcadia stream. Not technically there where the arrow is. We're a little more like kind of north of that. But to kind of give you an idea where we are, we're about 23,000 light years from Beagle Point. But yeah, there we are. And right down here, that is Goliath's Rest, center of the galaxy, obviously. So this will be, this is our, what, second stop or waypoint on this journey. And after that, we're going to Luna's Shadow right here, the fleet carrier Tartarus, and then finally over to Beagle Point. So this weekend, this Saturday, I'm going to be doing a bonus stream on Saturday starting at noon. Hopefully we can get to Luna's Shadow on Saturday. All right, before we go, let me check, make sure everything's good to go, and we'll check out Rendezvous Point. Okay, everything looks good. Yeah, I stopped us off just under 20 light years. All right, first jump of the stream. Let's see what Rendezvous Point looks like. This is a historic location where two early deep space explorers met. All right. Let's pick up a little bit of gas here. All right. I'd be surprised if there isn't a Taurus beacon here. All right. Let's take a look. Okay, icy bodies, gas giants. Of course, this system's not famous for what's in it, just what happens, so. Ooh, what's this? Wow. We got a lot of people. It's like this entire section's been mapped. I looked at the POI entry for this system on EDSM, and it looks like the last person to come here was June 20th of this year. And it, there's something in the neighborhood of like, there's like 2,000 something unique visitors to this system. So it's a fairly popular place for the most part. All down here. All right. Let's see what else we got here. Oh, wow. Look at the rings on that. Alright, I haven't found a concentrated signal source yet. So, I'm going to be very shocked if the devs didn't put a Taurus beacon out here. All right, let's see what's here. Huh. Really? Nothing? Huh. Well, I'm shocked that there's nothing here, not even a beacon. Kind of disappointing. So what's interesting, so the two commanders who first discovered this place, neither of them was Camzel there. So what happened was news about this spread on the forums, and before either of these commanders could turn in their data, this guy came and stole credit for it. So, you know. There's that little story. Well, damn, I was really hoping there'd be something here, but there's just like nothing. Class 1 gas giant. I wonder. Ooh, that one's got like 49 geological things. And you can tell people have come through here. What's your gravity? Oh, yeah, one. You know what? Let's at least land on one of these planets. Just to say that we have. Actually, hold on. Are any of these not mapped? I have a feeling they're all mapped, but let's take a look. Yep. Yep. I mean, I'm not surprised. It's a very well-known system, so. Yeah. Looks like everyone else had the same idea as me. Well, darn. Okay, well, let's at least, in the name of exploration, let's at least land on one of these planets. Maybe we'll get a nice shot of the gas giant it's orbiting. That might be fun, right? Oh, damn. was kind of hoping there'd be a little bit more. Well, maybe Luna's shadow will have a beacon that we can scan. All right, here we go. Got my little Martian bobblehead right there. Doo doo doo. Okay, rendezvous point 2A. And decrease our speed a bit. Wow, that's a really tight orbit. Oh, no, never mind. Those are just the rings. Okay. Okay, so it looks like we're going to be approaching on the dark side. It's nice looking rings, though. Now, I know someone else has already mapped it, but I need to map the surface to find some of those geological features. Easy enough. Easy peasy. All right, I guess we're gonna go with geographical point. Well, can we switch? Okay. Maybe geological signal 32 might be a better option. All right. I already checked. It's low G planet, so hope. Well, I'll try not to bang up the hull this time. How about that? Whoops. Getting a bit too. Pull up a bit. Ah, there we go. That's the skyline I was looking for right there. Honestly, any of these should be fine. So I'm pulling some hard G's. So yeah, if I can get just over that horizon. Okay. Okay, where's our closest? All right, 500 kilometers, huh? Yeah, that's not bad. All right, I think I can touch down. Yeah, I think I'll touch down right on this plateau here. Oh yeah, it's 0.15 Gs. We shouldn't have trouble landing. Let's deploy our landing gear. Okay. I'll just take her down nice and easy. Okay. There we go. Oh wow, look at that paint job. So really starting the show. All right. Okay, well, let's go check out those anomalies. All right, picking up some speed. All right. Perfect. I do love the I don't even know what you would call those. Those almost look like riverbeds, but I don't know. Ice planet, maybe. Who knows? All right. Well, I was hoping I could have gotten a little closer, but 20 kilometers is better than 500, so I'll go with that. I'll take it. Wow, this is a huge ravine, I guess. It's like I'm starting to see something. Geysers, maybe? Yeah, those look like geysers. All right. Let's go ahead and lower our speed a little bit. Oh, yeah. Whole bunch of geysers. Landing gear deployed. All right, let's see. I think... I think right outside this anomaly should be fine. All right, here we go. All right. Let's see. Which one do I want? I'll just power them both up. All right. Let's see. Which one do we want to take? That one's at 95 fuel. That's at 100. We'll take the one that's at 100 fuel. I hear that. Wow. This is pretty cool. Well, let's just head to some of that fog, smoke. Oh, what's that? Looks like there's some material out here. Come back for that later. All right, let me see. Am I missing something on you? There we go. Composition scanner. There we go. Biological and geographical discovery made. Water ice. Cool. Wow. You really get a sense of just how big these places are when you're actually, like, in the cockpit. All right. There we go. Switch over to combat mode real quick. Carbon. There we go. Okay. Carbon, huh? Well, let's see if these needle crystals have any more interesting drops. Ooh, hello. All right. It's a slightly more rare mineral. Ooh, germanium. Actually need some of that. I think I need it for either FSD boosters or something else. Okay, there's actually some really good minerals here. Or elements. Wow, there's a lot of stuff here. All right, well, I don't want the whole stream to be off-roading in an SRV collecting stuff, so. Ooh, tungsten. Yeah, that's some good stuff. All right. I mean, actually, some pretty good stuff here. Well, if you're out in this part of the galaxy and you need to restock on some minerals, that's the place to be. All right. Oops. All right. Yeah, carbon. Well, it's common, but never know. All right. Let's head back. Ooh, took a little damage. Okay, now I'm trying to show off. And make sure there's nothing else I need to scan. Well, unlike my ship, I can actually repair this little guy, so I'm not too worried. And I brought a spare, so. Oops. Come on. I'm always bad at finding that sweet spot. All right. Okay, well, that's going. Let me grab my next waypoint. Okay. Let's see what we got here. Set our next waypoint. Waypoint. Hopefully I can find some neutron stars along the way, but I doubt that's going to be the case. All right. Okay. Thing looks good here. All right. And just like that, we're off. Okay, let's get. So we can break this mass lock. Okay. Once we hit, yeah, I have a feeling it's going to be on the other side of this rock. Let's see, and we're heading away from, we're heading away from the big planet. Actually, there it is right there. Rendezvous point 2B. There's a Shakespeare joke in there somewhere. But I'm not interested in you. I'm interested in you. Hopefully I don't get mass locked. Goodbye, planet. And just like that, we're back on the road. Though that was a fun little distraction, landing on a planet. Collecting stuff. Scanning stuff. Ooh. I'll have to see if I'm going to... It's actually the first time I've scanned a... geographical feature before, so I wonder if I've got any. Oh, look at that! 50,000 credits codex entry. Nice. Alright, I'm going to assume. Wizard motor, yeah, someone else has found this. Icy bodies, yeah, I'm not too worried about this. Rendezvous point is such a well-known system that we're probably going to have a lot of discoveries, not discoveries, a lot of the stars around it have probably already been discovered, so I'm not going to waste too much time here. So you'll notice that the stars are a lot denser out here. That's because we're crossing one of the voids in the galaxy. I don't know what they're called. I'm just going to call them voids. It's basically the dark spot between galactic arms, for lack of a better term. Actually, Yeah. Let's see, icy bodies, gas giants, asteroid. Yeah, nothing interesting here. Wow, 68 bodies, damn. If there's anything interesting here. Right, first things first. Wrong map. Let's see if anyone's found this place yet. Yeah, I'm gonna go with yes. Yep. See if there's anything interesting. Gas giant, gas giant. A lot of gas giants. I see bodies. Yeah, asteroid clusters. Yeah, nothing. Nothing too interesting. Two, one, engage. Twenty bodies here, huh? Yeah, I'm going to assume. Yep. Same guy, too. Two more jumps till we hit our first neutron highway. Yeah, probably not a lot of neutron stars here. Well, this is promising. Maybe no one's found this place yet. Nope, same dude. But I don't think he bothered scanning all these planets. He did not. we're just going off the assumption that all these other bodies... Oh, no. Looks like we've got a few by themselves. Never mind. My assumption was incorrect. Let's see. Okay. I doubt any of these are going to be noteworthy. But some of these bodies might have mineral deposits that other commanders can use, so it's always worth scanning them just in case. Icy bodies. All right. They're all ice bodies, so I doubt any of them were candidates. Yeah, those are all ice bodies, it looks like. All right. Well, that was a nice little excursion. All right. All right, this will be our first neutron boost of the stream. I'll try not to screw it up too bad. Well, not my best, but I've had worse. I'll take it. Okay.
No, that's not right.
What?
No, that can't be right. There we go, that's better. That was weird. There we go. Okay, that's more like it. Engage. Ooh. This neutron star wasn't on my flight plan. Have you been discovered yet? Oh, hey, it's that guy. Denholm. I'm not going to worry too much about a couple rocky bodies. All right, let's go. All right, well, that's going. There we go. Just loaded my next destination onto the clipboard. Okay. That looks like a pretty good path. Three jumps. Wow, looks like we're going to be on a bit of the neutron highway.
right. Well, let's see. We might be able to hit the 50% mark on this leg before the end of the stream. We'll see. Oh, damn. I haven't been doing a good job keeping an eye on my fuel. Okay, we'll see if we can find a point a little further than that. All right. Let's see if we can find a spot that's a little further than that. Da, 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 da. That's a little better. Let's see if we can get a little further. Yeah, that looks like a good one. Trying to maximize my jump range. Might be a new discovery, who knows? We'll find out. At the very least, it's a fuel star, so I can replenish my reserves. Well, so far, so good. This might be a first discovery. All right. You'll be okay. Yeah. Temperature critical, but no damage done. Target too close. Yeah, I guess so. You could burn your instruments out looking at that thing. I twist. I am small, but my reach is long. Such a pity about Game of Thrones ending the way it did. Actual ending I didn't have an issue with. It was the lack of, they needed like another season to flesh everything out. I think I've talked about this on the stream, actually. Okay. Okay, I got my coordinate. What the hell? Let's see. I already know those two water worlds. I'm going to scan them regardless. I'm sorry. Map them, not scan them. I've already scanned them. I'm going to map them. Okay, so you're a candidate. Okay. So we only have one candidate. Okay, that's fine. But here, this is where the two water worlds are on this other star. Not yet mapped, not yet mapped, not yet mapped. Water world and a candidate. All right. And just a regular one. Cool. All right. Well, we'll get this one, and then we'll fly over to the second star and get the other two. Not a bad little paycheck, I think. And I believe this is also a first discovery. Okay, so at 0.4 light seconds, I'm going to cut the throttle. And that should put us at the right distance. All right, nailed that. Now, let's see. Okay. And I believe it was just those two, right? Yeah. Yep, just those two. Okay, cool. And now we wait. Still can't believe that I took 10% hull damage last stream. Ugh. Oh, well. I'll repair the ship at the Tartarus fleet carrier when we get there. And I'm probably, if everything goes as well, I'll get that last, like, 6% of my rank, so I'll be elite. Ugh. Finally have my elite wings. I'm thinking about changing the registration number for my ship. Because right now it's Romeo Foxtrot, TAC 04. But whenever the space traffic control... they refer to me as Romeo Echo Delta, which is the first three letters of my commander's name. So I figure I might as well just have that as a prefix for all my ships. So this ship will be Romeo Echo Delta 04. And then I'll leave one character. So, you know, like for example, the Peregrine is... Right now, it's Romeo Foxtrot TAC 02 Alpha. So its new registration will be Romeo Echo Delta 02 Alpha. Because it's the second ship that I bought, but it's also the second ship to have that name. Kind of like Enterprise A, NCC 1701A, and B. Yeah, sort of like that. Now, I was looking at the requirements for elite in trading. It's like, for elite rank, I think you have to make a total of over 1 billion credits trading. Which seems like a lot. And it is. But with a Type 9... heavy transport, it's doable. It's very doable. And I should have more than enough money when I get back to the bubble. I hate how catchy this song is. I don't think of it. I never finished GTA 4. I need to get on that. Especially since the protagonist is a Eastern European immigrant. My people. All right. Last one, and then we're out of this system. And then we wait. All right. That's two candidates, one of which was a water world, and then a regular water world, plus first discovery bonus and efficiency bonus. Nice little payout. I think one of the systems I discovered off stream was worth something like 10 million credits, because it was something like four or five candidate worlds. It was kind of dumb. Like a stupid amount of candidates. Well, hello there. Really? I haven't discovered a type A yet? Huh. Oh, and a Y type. Okay. Interesting. See if anyone's found this place yet. Oh, doesn't look like anyone's discovered this place yet. Okay. Whoa. Okay. Another water world. Interesting. I am not complaining. I'll take it. What is that? Two water worlds? What? Oh no, is this three? Three water worlds. Hold on now. Three water worlds in the same system. I've never seen this before. I've seen two, like we just saw. That is insane. I wonder if any of them are candidates. We're gonna find out, won't we? Wow. Okay, one more. All right, let's see if we have any good candidates in this system. Damn, three. Three water worlds. That's a record for me. I don't know what the record for most water worlds in a single system is. It's probably like half a dozen or something. Okay, so you're a candidate. You're a candidate. You're a candidate. You're not a candidate, but you're still a water world, so you're gonna get scanned anyway. Well, damn. Okay, wow, that's wild. I got nothing. That's new. All right, I doubt any of these moons are going to be good candidates. No, they're all like rocky bodies. Yeah, you're all rocky bodies. Good source of minerals, I'm sure, but not. Okay. 1,100. No. I'm sorry. What am I? I can't talk right now. 112,000 light seconds. Yeah, I think it's worth it. For three damn water worlds? Yeah, I'll do it. All right, it's been a while since I checked the chat. I'm gonna do that right now. Okay, no activity on the chat. Yeah, it's gonna take me a while to get there. Let's see here. Eight more jumps until I hit my next neutron star. Well, the next destination on my map. That is insane. Three water worlds. I still can't get over that. RNG gods are smiling on me tonight, huh? So apparently the frameshift drive has a limit of 2001C, which I thought was interesting. I've gotten close to that. I've gotten up to like 1700, and that was when I was doing the run to Hutton Orbital in Alpha Centauri. Which, if anyone tells you you get a free Anaconda for going there, no. That's just something they tell the new commanders. It's a funny joke, though, especially if you waste your time. I actually went there for an EDSM achievement. There's a achievement for docking at Hutton Orbital. Well, it's not an achievement, it's a badge. And it's kind of a rite of passage and all that, so. But it's really funny because Hutton doesn't even have a large landing pad on it, so. Yeah, I don't know. That just makes the Anaconda joke even funnier. So. No, I plan on buying my own Anaconda eventually. It's still the best ship in the game for jump range. You can get some stupid range on that thing. I think you can get it up to, well, someone was able to get an Anaconda to jump. They did some really, like, interesting hacks and exploits with the engineering. Such as, like, equipping a power plant that you shouldn't be able to equip and some other weird stuff. I think they were able to get it with a neutron boost. It was, like, well over 300. Maybe it was 350? I don't remember. A boost. Boost jump, not a, like, regular jump. I think the regular jump was in the upper 80s, I want to say. Because you can engineer an Anaconda to get a jump range of 80 light years pretty easily without doing anything too crazy. And that's probably going to be my final tier exploration ship is going to be an Anaconda. But there's a few other ships I'm going to get in between there. Eventually, I want to get a Type 9 and a Python. I'm going to have my own little fleet eventually. Actually, I kind of do have my own fleet because I got a Sidewinder, Cobra Mark III. And a Diamondback Explorer. I had to think about what ship model they were because I was thinking about their names, their actual like ship names, the names that I gave them. Sparrow, Peregrine, and Kestrel in that order. Okay, good. Looks like we're under the influence of our destination star's gravity well. So we're past the halfway point. Was 5 one of them? I got plenty of time. I can look at it. Okay, let's see here. Give it a second here. Okay, not yet. Map this planet. I gotta map this planet. Okay, so it is 4, 5, 6, and 7. 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. All right. Works for me. Okay, I think I finally figured out the optimum place to put my neck so I can look out without the two side windows popping up. Those of you watching at home, you have a nice little crosshair in the middle of the screen. I don't have that, so that's actually something that I superimposed on the stream to help people with motion sickness. Which is funny. Months ago, when I first got my VR headset, I always got a little queasy when I was in the SRV, and now I don't even feel it anymore. So your body does adjust over time to, dealing with VR. Because if I remember correctly, the whole thing that causes motion sickness is your eyes detect something that your inner ear doesn't. And at some point we evolved the reflex to get motion sickness and vomit, because that's one of the signs of poisoning. So it's just one of those things you have to, and for some people it's worse than others, and it's just kind of comes down to genetics, I guess. I don't know. Makes sense to me, at least. Okay, so here's 5 and 6. Let's get these two taken care of. Wow, we're already 3/4 into the stream already. Whew. Man, time is flying by. I just happened to glance up at my clock there. Okay. And now we wait. Okay, that ought to do it. Good. Okay, so there's 5 and 6. Damn, I'm getting better at that. Okay, cool. All right. Okay, that's 5 and 6. There's 7. And then 4. Okay, so 4. I don't know why I'm pointing. 4. 5, 6, 7. Right? Yeah. I think that's it. It's kind of over there a bit. Yeah, other side of the system, looks like. Ah. Well, put a dollar in the swear jar. Another loop of shame. But I've gotten really good at recovering from them, so that's something, right? Okay. All right, we will see. Oh, wow. Look at that. I haven't even, like, looked at the skybox. Wow, that is beautiful. Okay. D7. 4. All right. That should be fine. That should be enough time for me to look at this. All right, let's see what we got here. Okay. You have not mapped. You have mapped. You have mapped. You have mapped. And high metal content world, not worth mapping. Okay, cool. Good stuff. Yeah, hopefully Tartarus has the facilities there to, like, re-register my ship and put my new wings on. We'll find out probably next Wednesday if I get my way and I can, because I think I have just under 10,000 light years to cover, and then I think it's another 6,000 light years from Luna's shadow to Tartarus. So we'll see. Wow. That glass is very streaky. I guess they don't have Windex in the future. Or that just could be like space dust. I don't know. I hate it when I get that notification for planets I'm not locked on to. It's a little freaky. I'm like, what? But I'm like 24 seconds away from it. All right, candidate high metal content world. There is definitely a lot of quality of life stuff the devs could be putting into this game. I don't know what the hell they're doing. Well, they're releasing the whole, like, Space Legs Odyssey expansion, so I guess that's something, but I don't know. At least have a small team dedicated to, you know, quality of life patches, but whatever. The community is very vocal about it on the official forum, so I'm not saying anything that hasn't already been said. All right. Okay, now we wait. I think that's the Skull Nebula. That might be another galaxy. I have no idea. Oh yeah, we're good. All right. Good find. Thank you, RNG. Random number generator. Still kind of freaky having this tiny body. Like, the last time my body was this small, I was a child. Let's see if there's anything here that might be worth looking at. Nope, nothing. Nothing on the spectrometer. All right. Actually, how far away are we from the 50? Okay, I just checked, and we're still, like, about 3,000 light years from the halfway point of this leg of our journey. Now, I'm going to say this now, and I'm going to say it again. Getting to Beagle Point is half of the journey. Because we still have to get back. Because there's a reason they say, that a test of an explorer's skill or an achievement for an explorer is to get to Beagle Point and return. Anyone can get there. Well, I want to say, well, you could probably make the trip in a Sidewinder. It'd be slow, and you'd hate yourself, but you could do it. Though I highly recommend if you want to try that and get a couple other a couple smaller expeditions under your belt. Like, travel a couple thousand light years outside the bubble, so you're not like super far away. And you can watch all the videos and do all the research you want, but until you're actually out here in the black doing this stuff, you're gonna make mistakes. And my point is, it's better to make those mistakes closer to a port. Actually, probably a really good first expedition might be just to go to Colonia, because every few thousand light years, there's a station you can visit. So that would be my advice to any would-be explorers watching. I think that was a first discovery too. Good. Oh, so my running tally of first discoveries, last I checked, I think I was up to like 340 first discoveries. So pretty good. And I mean, that's really low. That's nothing. There are explorers that have a couple hundred thousand first discoveries to their credit. In fact, the lower end of the top 100 discoveries, pilots by discoveries, is something like it starts at like. The 100th position is like 25,000. Nope. I got a ways to go. I doubt I'll ever be that up there. And I've always been one of those people that I could never play an MMO too long because eventually it felt like a job. And there are just so many other games, different games I want to play. So I usually don't stick to one for very long. Plus, I just don't have the free time. And the free time that I do have, I have other projects I'd rather work on. Skills to develop, that sort of stuff. Oh, so just stars in this one, huh? See what we got here. Nope. Just stars. I mean, it's a fuel star. That's good enough for me. 1.7 mil. Rebuy, huh? Hmm. Wow, I have not seen a single neutron star. I guess there just aren't any in range. Okay, let's see what we got here. Nope, nothing on the spectrometer. Oh, wow. Look at that. I didn't even look at that. That is beautiful. I want to say that's the galactic plane. Like, galactic center is back that way. Wow. Huh. This game truly, especially in VR, it really kind of captures that sense of exploration and just really put you into the beauty of the galaxy or the universe, really. Ooh, a water world. Hello. Hopefully that water world is near the star I'm at, but we'll find out, won't we? Yeah, I'm not seeing anyone's names on these, so I'm going to assume this is a first discovery. Come on, where are you? There we go. Something over here. Hopefully there's nothing behind the star. We'll find out shortly, won't we? Kind of look like Mars. Of course, the water world is on a different star. Okay, well. Okay, who else we got? Only wonder where we're fighting back. Fire of every Templar, every mage. Caught in their crossfire of their politics and greed. Had to pull some strings and knock them off each other's back. There were greater dangers waiting to attack. Okay. Going to assume these are all like ice planets. Yeah. That's a really close water world. I'm surprised the water isn't like water vapor. Steam? There we go. Steam. Okay. Wow. 208,000 light seconds. Does anyone have their name on this system? We're about to find out. Nope. This is my discovery. Sure, why not? I've got two more jumps. I think I'll end the stream once we reach our destination after two jumps. Doesn't look like we're going to be hitting anything, any milestones after that. Ooh, but look at that. Wow. Yeah, I got plenty of time. Look at that. Wow, that is something. I'll be curious to see what all that looks like from Beagle Point. I saw a picture. I'm actually using it as a thumbnail. Someone with an SRV parked at one of the planets around Beagle Point, and it was just this little rover, and then. Well, I mean, you've seen the picture probably. And then, like, you can just see Beagle Point. And then you can see the galaxy from that point. I want to definitely recreate that shot. Honestly, I'm probably going to use it as my new thumbnail once I take it. Yeah, we're going to be here a while. Oh, so video game front. I recently purchased Doom Eternal. I was a big fan of the 2016 Doom reboot. I think id Software did a lot of good stuff with that. You know, it wasn't perfect. I had a few criticisms of it. But for the most part, I was very happy with what they did with the franchise. And Doom Eternal is pretty much all that up to 11. It's really fun. It's kind of funny because prior to that I was playing Halo. I was a little over halfway through the original Halo, and man, first Halo's a bit of a bear in a few spots. Not due to difficulty, just because of level design. Like, there are just some parts of that where it's just the levels just drag on too long, and it's the same crap copy pasted, and there are times where you have to return to them, and it's just it's a real bear to get through. And we kind of have Halo to blame for some of the direction the first-person shooter went. And the 2010s and even like the late 2000s. I'm talking about stuff like regenerating health and, you know, two weapon rule or limited weapon inventory rule and all that stuff. It's just, I don't want to hide behind cover to regenerate my health. I'd rather rip a monster's face in half and get health that way, you know? And that's where I think Doom Eternal really, they emphasize, it's a lot of, it's fascinating. It's a lot of the old school first person shooter mentality of, well, obviously the original Doom games and, you know, like Quake and all that, you know, high mobility, dodging attacks, you know, twitch based, shooting. It's all there. Not regenerating health. But what I really love about the Doom reboot and the 2016 Doom is, I'm sorry, the Doom reboot, the 2016 Doom reboot and Doom Eternal is, to get health, you have to perform glory kills on your enemies. So when they're like staggered, you know, you do a melee attack on them basically, and you get to, you know, mess them up. And that's how you get health. You can also, there's like health pickups laying around. So, you know, rather than like hiding in a corner waiting for your health to regenerate, you're actually like pushing forward. I think they actually call it like pushing forward mechanics. So you're essentially rewarded for being a badass. And Duke Nukem Forever, for all of its flaws, I think if it had implemented a system like that, it would have been better. I'm not saying it'd be perfect, but it would be better. And the irony is, the earliest game I can think of that had this so-called like pushing forward type mechanic was one of the side-scrolling Duke Nukem games, which is funny because you actually gained health by damaging enemies. And I'm sure there's some games that implemented that mechanic way earlier, but I don't know. It's like it's a very underused gameplay mechanic, and I hope to see more of that in future games. But you know, we'll see. Hopefully, it doesn't become so overused that you just get sick of it, like cover-based regenerative health. It's just boring. But really, and really been enjoying Doom Eternal. It's, like I said, if you didn't like the 2016 Doom reboot, you're not going to like this one, but I liked it just fine, and they improved on it a lot, so I'm pretty happy with it. Yeah, I bought it on sale. There's a it was during the QuakeCon sale. I got it for 50% off. So I was like, ooh, you know what? Yeah, I might as well. Because I usually don't buy new games unless they're on sale. And there's so many, like, little Easter eggs in there. Like, I found a hidden element, an Easter egg in the game, which was clearly supposed to be Slimer from Ghostbusters. And I thought that was cute. I was like, oh, that's nice. Well, we're slowing down. So we are definitely under the influence of our target star's gravity well. That's good. Oh. Yeah, I don't know what it is. Like, recently I've just had this appreciation for old school first person shooters, like, you know, stuff like original Doom, Doom 2, Hexen, Blood. What else? Duke Nukem 3D. You know, all these, you know, name any build engine game, Shadow Warrior, all this stuff. Just, I don't know. There's just something. I don't know. I just can't put my finger on it. Duke Nukem 3D was innovative for its time just because of the level of detail, even in a game of that age. I mean, you could go into, like, you know, a strip club, and you could play pool, and, you know, play with the slot machines and stuff, and, yeah, tip strippers a 20. Okay, yeah, so some of that stuff doesn't quite, wouldn't work as well in today's climate, but, you know. Definitely was a product of its time, I'll say that much. But early destructible environments, secrets. I think that was something I always liked, was finding the secrets. That was something that always attracted me to Doom. It wasn't necessarily the shooting of monsters, it was the exploration aspect. And that's something that I find I'm really enjoying in Doom Eternal, because they've got all these, like, secrets you can find. And it's almost like a puzzle in a way, because once you can get upgrades for your suit, and you can kind of see, you can see where these hidden things are, but you don't quite, you don't always know how to get there, and so part of the fun is figuring out how to get there. So. And now, I mean, especially with all these, like, run-of-the-mill military shooters, you're discouraged from exploring at all. Like, you'll actively, the game will quit, basically. Oh, not quit. You'll get a mission failure screen and then dropped at the last checkpoint if you wander too far away from the mission. It's like, well, that's no fun. At least Doom, they made it interesting. It's like, oh, yeah. Well, early Doom, you're pretty much in a box, so you couldn't go anywhere. But, you know, they at least tried to make it interesting. I don't know. I like games that reward exploration. Which makes sense, because I'm heading to the edge of the galaxy in this game. Oh, well. I'm really looking forward to Baldur's Gate 3 Early Access. Ooh, I know it's just like the first part of the first chapter, but I'm so looking forward to it. Talk about a game that rewards exploration. The Dragon Age. Why am I saying Dragon Age? The Divinity games. Ugh. Well, that's another dollar in the swear jar. Guess I should focus on flying more than chatting, huh? Yeah, game that rewards exploration and experimentation. That's the kind of stuff I like. And there are just so many games, especially from, like, major publishers, where it's just, shoot the thing till it dies. Okay, great. Now go to the next place we tell you and shoot those things until they die. It's like, boring. I want something a little, something else. But I guess they make money because they sell. Okay, boom. All right. Okay. Two more jumps, then I think I'll call it for the night. But, you know, we got to witness something pretty historical. I've never seen a system with three water worlds. So that was some RNG magic, I think. All right. Let's see if there's anything worth looking for. Ooh, water worlds. Damn. Just, I don't know what it is. Just finding a lot of water worlds today. Yeah, this looks like a system no one's discovered yet. And yeah, I'm saying that with the assumption in mind that someone might have already scanned it and they just haven't turned their data in yet. And so I'm fully aware of that. Ooh, I don't know. This water world's kind of close. I doubt it's a candidate, but at least it's, you know. Okay. Where are you? All right. Oh, let's see if there's anything behind the star. Good. Nothing behind the star. Good. That's annoying. All right. Okay, let's see. So where else besides that water world should I map? Let's see. Whoa. Okay. Not a candidate, not a candidate, not a candidate. Okay. All right, well, that planet. Before we do that, let's see. Oh, look at that. Candidate. Candidate and a water world. Not a candidate. Okay, cool. All right, well, let's get this guy first. I don't know why I said guy. It's a planet. Its pronouns is it. But whatever. Let's go grab this. Grab this planet. That planet was a lot closer than I had expected, so. Alright, what? That's $3 in the swear jar? Alright. All right, now we wait. Okay. Okay, and I believe that was 1 and 2. Let me double check. Always good to check again. Yeah, I think it was 1 and 2. 1, 2. Yep. Yep, 1 and 2. Oh, I haven't checked the chat in a while. Okay, no activity on the chat. Though I did notice we have a second person. Hello, second person. Apologies for not recognizing you sooner. VR headset and all that. Can't see the chat. All right. Well, this Saturday I'll be doing another stream at 12 p.m. Eastern time. I'm going to work really hard to get us to Luna's Shadow before then. I think I can do it. It's just a matter of, well, doing it. So Saturday will be Luna's Shadow, and then Wednesday, hopefully, depending on how much work I, how much progress I make over the weekend, will be the fleet carrier Tartarus, where we'll dock. I'll turn in my data. I've said this before and I was wrong, but I don't see me not getting elite by then. 94% in the Pioneer. Though at the time when I said that originally, I was like 50-something percent into Pioneer. So I'll get my wings, my elite wings, and exploration. Just in time to hit Beagle Point, which Beagle Point, I want to hit Beagle Point by week after next. And then we start leg 4, which will be our first return trip. But we'll talk more about that as it comes up. Right now, we're not even halfway through this leg, so I'm not gonna, you know. Like I said, one thing at a time. And I think, did I mention that in this stream or not? So I use a third-party tool to map out neutron stars. And I always wait until just before I'm about to start the leg of the trip to calculate the journey, simply because people are constantly contributing, discovering systems and updating EDSM. So a route that you plotted 6 weeks ago, there may be a more efficient route later on. So that's why I always wait. Come on, slow down. Oh, damn. Did I make that classic mistake? Oh, no. 1 and 2 are right near each other. Okay, good. The classic mistake is assuming that the planet that has the closer orbit is closer to you, because that's not always the case. Depending on how you approach a system or approach a star, the planets that have a outer orbit might actually be closer to you. Which is why I use the left panel there to, because it sorts by closest. All right. Oh, yeah, we got this. This old hat now. Okay, let's see what we got here. Oh, too fast, too fast. Oh boy. Okay, that's $4 in the swear jar now. that kind of snuck up on me. All right, there we go. Okay, I'm way too close to this planet, but I think I'll be all right. Huh, I'm like right here looking at the... I'm going to assume the South Pole. Could be the North Pole. It's all relative, right? All right. Let's see here. Let's take one last look. Or gander, if you would. Yeah. You have mapped. You have mapped. And the rest of those are ice planets. Okay. All right. You know, it's funny. I always plan for these streams to be right at 2 hours, but they always end up going a little over, like about 20, sometimes 40 minutes. Just because, you know, you never know. Stuff comes up. All right. All right, I think that's where I'm going to leave it today. I want to thank all of you for watching this week's stream. Again, remember, I've got a bonus stream happening at 12 p.m. Eastern on Saturday. I'll post an announcement on my Twitter account. And you can keep up with all the news about this channel and when streams are happening on my Twitter, at RedFalcon2K6. Streams are minimum once a week, every Wednesday at 5 p.m. Eastern. And let's see what else. Oh, archives of these streams are on my YouTube channel. And you can find those just by going to YouTube and searching for Red Falcon Expedition to Beagle Point. You'll find me. Also, I've got the link at the end credits here. Let's see. I think that's about it. Let me check the chat one last time. All right, everyone's been quiet, so I guess I'll see everyone on Saturday. If anything changes, it'll be on Twitter. So, all right, well, all of you be safe out there.